Ooh, check it out. It's a monkey with a stick up its butt. Dance for me, stick butt monkey. Welcome to Tranny Star Galactica. I'm Sama, and topic number 124 is by Jen. Do you remember the first time you realized you were transgender? Where is your favorite place you've ever been? Where would you like to go that you've never been? I suppose the first time the word applied to me was about two and a half, three years ago. I sort of figured it out the hard way, I suppose. I don't think there's an easy way to figure that out. It sounds so cliche to say, but it's true. So I'm going to let it out there. In my kindergarten class, there was like this scaffolding. It was supposed to be a house, you know, and kids could play house during recess. And there's this girl, Erica, who was always the mother, and there was always Esty, who was the kid, and I always wanted to be the dad and couldn't be. But there were no boys who wanted to play house, of course. And so I was like, yeah, house is stupid. So there's that. So it was about 2.5 years ago that I started identifying as trans. And it was a really strange sort of realization because it was a matter of putting together things that had always been, not necessarily a matter of making any decisions or changes at that point in time. So it's nice because I had already been me for some time. So there was no need to make any major changes in order to stay me. It's really just that the word did a great deal of good for me in bringing out my self-confidence and my willingness to present as me and not as some idea of what society was supposed to see of me. So question number two. Where is your favorite place that you've ever been? Home. Niagara Falls is my favorite place in the whole world. That whole area, Toronto, Buffalo, but there's a particular couple of spots at Niagara Falls. There's two on the Canadian side and one on the American side that when I stand there, I absolutely have a sense of who I am. And nothing is ever on my mind when I'm there. There's never anything else that I'm thinking about. It's just this colossal mass of water that could care less about who I am and whether or not I'm trans or what I'm wearing or what I like for breakfast. It doesn't matter. There are certain things that are a priority when it's just me versus millions or billions of years. It makes the situations that we hold against each other as humans insignificant in the grand scheme of things. And there's just nothing more comforting than the idea that all of my troubles are very, very small in comparison with the universe. Not to get too cosmic, but it's the truth. I mean, proportionately, hello. Every week you interrupt. Okay, take a walk. Thank you. So anyway, last bonus question. Where would you like to go that you've never been? Alaska. First of all, I want to see someplace colder than Buffalo. I want to know what that's like. And second of all, I'd like to visit an archipelago because I'd like to say archipelago. I'd just like to see the style of living there. I think it would be fun. So let's go back to the first topic for another second. Because the first time you realize that you're transgender, I think you don't have a word for it. You just have this sense of disparity. And it's something that you sort of live with, like being cranky forever. Until there's a context for it that makes sense. So, excuse you. We're almost done here. I think we're done here. Okay, say goodbye, giant kitty. Goodbye. Say goodbye, giant kitty. Okay. I'll see you next week. Be well.